Hello, my name is Kylie, and I'm a communications officer for the Waterloo Region District School Board. Today we are speaking to Noriko Fukumoto, a special education teacher with our board. Thank you for joining us today, Noriko.
Thanks so much for having me. I'm really happy to be here.
Tell me about what your role as a special education resource teacher does.
So my role as a special education resource teacher, or a CERT, is to collaborate with and support students, their families, and staff. I love my role as a CERT because of the relationships I'm building with students and their families, as I usually get to work with them from grade 9 until graduation. The largest portion of my day is spent supporting the academic, social, and emotional needs of students, but I also spend a lot of time working with staff and the student success team to develop plans to best support students.
You are used to working with students one-on-one, face-to-face. How has distance learning changed the way you've provided support?
Well, this has definitely been the most challenging part of my role over distance learning, adapting and transitioning from face-to-face support to connecting from a distance. Over distance learning, the tool I've used the most in order to help me stay connected is the phone. I have weekly or sometimes twice a week scheduled calls with the students who I worked with regularly when we were in the school. The support I provide over the phone can include scribing, organization, and scheduling, but most often I'm encouraging students and listening to how things are going for them and their families.
What are some ways you have engaged your learning strategy students in their learning while they are at home?
So I've tried to create activities and assignments that are practical, easy to do at home, and help students to develop transferable skills. For example, I created assignments surrounding the importance of connections to our planet and our own well-being. Students needed to demonstrate different ways that our connection to the planet is important. I provide them with choice, so they could write about their experiences, take pictures, have a phone conversation with me, create art, use music, or really tap into any of their strengths or passions. A popular choice for this activity was discovering gardening. I myself have never really gardened, so I use my experience as an example in my lesson, as I've taken this opportunity to learn alongside my students even while we are apart.
What has been your main learning focus with your students since moving to the distance learning environment?
So I decided to focus on ensuring student well-being. I've woven these topics into every week of GLE, and I also discuss this with my students every time we speak on the phone.
How has it made you feel hearing from your students?
Hearing from my students can definitely be the highlight of my day. A part of my role that I really enjoy is checking in with them, getting to hear about their week, their highs and lows, and building relationships.
And lastly, the well-being of all of our students has been a priority during this time of distance learning. What suggestions would you have to parents and caregivers on how best to support our students during this time?
So my best advice to parents and our students during this time is to please reach out to a staff member with anything. There is no question or problem too little that we do not want to help you find the answer to or provide you with support for.
Thank you for joining us today, Noriko. It's been a pleasure speaking with you and learning about your position as a CERT, and we hope that you have a wonderful and relaxing summer. Thank you.
Thank you so much for having me, Kylie.